So this epiphytic fern is known as Phlebodium aureum, and aureum essentially means golden yellow. And I should have actually brought one of my smaller ones because it was easier to see this, but if you could get a little sneak peek in there, you'll see some little golden yellow fuzz kind of popping up there on the rhizome. And that is how it gets its species name, aureum, of that golden yellow. So it does kind of creep along and get this really fuzzy rhizome, which is this kind of creeping stem that looks like an above ground root. Now, this is commonly known as blue star fern, so that's maybe how you know it. It's a very popular houseplant. I find that epiphytic ferns are really easy to grow indoors, and although I have struggled with this in a couple conditions, and I have a number of these growing in my house, and I have tested it in various different places, and I have found that in my green wall, it does not like to be there, and I think because of the wetness and then the drying out, it just doesn't really... it's not the most optimal conditions for this plant. However, growing it in pots seems to be a good move, especially like terracotta pots, because it is an epiphytic fern, so it doesn't necessarily need to be moist all the time like some other ferns. So I think that's part of the reason why I suggest that this is a little bit more of an easier fern to be able to handle. Now, what I found with my smaller fern that's in my northeast facing window is I inherited like this little tiny blue star fern, and it was like putting out all these like beautiful fronds along its rhizome. And I found out that my house mice, which I have gotten a handle of, by the way, but some house mice gnawed on the leaves and also gnawed on the stem. I still have that plant. It just looks a little bit like, it looks a little sad. But what I love about ferns is that even if you kind of cut out off some of those leaves, it starts to put out these little fronds down below, and it's not all for naught. So even the blue star ferns that were in my green wall, if they kind of dried out, it almost is not that big of a deal. But unfortunately, with a green wall, you want to have it a little bit more lush looking all the time. So I have a tendency to kind of move some of those plants out if they're not looking as lush, or if they're getting enshrouded by other plants and they're just kind of darkening out the leaves below. But back to Phlebodium. This is a plant that has a large range. So it's all throughout Central and South America, and actually even extends up into the US. So you could probably find it in Florida and Georgia, growing in all sorts of different kinds of beautiful conditions. And it, like I said, it's become a very, very popular houseplant. Typically, I find it's a little bit easier to care for. And as far as fertilizing goes, you could get away with maybe on a monthly basis and just do a really well-balanced fertilizer. It's like a 1-1-1 if you're going the organic route, or maybe a 10-10-10 if you're going through the synthetic route. And as far as plant pests go, this is a very resilient fern, which I can't say about all ferns, because I feel like my rabbit's foot ferns always get scale on them. And this one just seems to be a little bit more immune to pest pressures. But I would love to hear how your trials and tribulations of blue star ferns have been going for you in your home. So share more in the comments below, and let me know if you've had an easy time growing blue star fern in your home.